ballot. Let's talk about double C right now. Proposition CC. If you want to learn more, I'd go to VoteNoOnCC.com. VoteNoOnCC.com. Lindsey Singer filling in for Michael Fields this morning. Colorado, a wonderful group out of Colorado saying no on this thing as well. Lindsey, welcome to the program.
Thank you for having me. And we're from Colorado Rising Action. Michael, I'm sorry he couldn't join you this morning, but he, because we don't have the out-of-state money that the Yes campaign has, we're using our grassroots efforts, trying to get on the radio, trying to talk to as many groups as possible, which is what Michael's doing this morning, to tell people to vote no on Prop CC, because if you just read the ballot language, it starts off without raising taxes, which is just not true, because when the government is keeping and spending more of our tax dollars, that's a tax increase.
Yeah, that is a tax increase. Let me back up. You just hit something that very passing, but it's very true, that a lot of these ads that we're seeing about vote yes on CC and all the promises and all the things that it's saying, that's not people from Colorado paying for that. That's not a grassroots effort in Colorado and people contributing to the campaign. A lot of that money's coming from New York. Let me ask the question of you. What vested interest do these out-of-state organizations and funding mechanisms, why are they so interested in Proposition CC in Colorado?
That's a great question. And I would say it's people who are against the taxpayer's Bill of Rights to begin with, and see Proposition CC as a step in fully repealing Tabor in the next couple of years.
Now let's talk about what CC does. If people voted for CC, which we're giving up our refunds and saying that they get to keep them indefinitely, so your tax refunds, you're just going to give them to Jared Polis and whoever's the governor, whoever the legislature is, they don't have to give those taxpayer Bill of Rights refunds back to you. That's the nutshell of it.
That's right. And people might not think it's a huge deal because maybe we haven't noticed or haven't received tax refunds in a number of years. But what happens is, I think the last time was 2015, and it gets given back to you in the form of a income tax reduction on your in your check. So you may not get a check in the mail that says this is your Tabor tax refund, but over the next 3 years, Jared Polis is estimating that it's going to be $1.7 billion of refunds that we would get back. But what the legislature is asking us is to keep that forever, so it wouldn't just be the $1.7 billion, it would be our children's tax refunds and so forth. And they would be able to spend that on, in your ballot, you'll see that they want to spend it on public schools, higher education, and roads, but that is not guaranteed. There's no guarantee past this coming year that has to go there, because it's not a constitutional, it's in the statute, which doesn't seem like a big deal, but the legislature can really take that money and put it towards whatever they want, including, we're hearing there's already $100 million debt that the legislature has for 2020. So, you know, I would put my $100 million if I had it on the fact that the legislature will spend our tax money filling in their holes.
Yeah, and I think sometimes these propositions get, they're told to support them because of the mysterious, it's for the children, it's for the schools or whatever. But I just wonder if Colorado, maybe, and hopefully in other states as well, but start to see through this nonsense because, you know, mill tax levy overrides, mill levy overrides and things like that. We give to these school districts, and then we're still told that they're not performing well. So at some point, maybe Colorado would see through it and say, you know, you say it's for the kids, you say it's for the schools, but that's what you've told me on the last several tax increases. So maybe you need to fix something else besides just fixing a way to take money out of my paycheck.
Right. And if you're looking at the education system, I think a lot of people would say that we are giving more money towards education, but despite it's about 20% increase in the last 10 years in education funding. But in that same time, it's about 20% decrease in teacher pay, which I think if you talk to a lot of people, is where people want to see that increase in education money going, because it directly impacts our students and their teachers. But this Proposition CC funding actually says that it cannot go to teacher pay, because we don't know how much will be there from year to year, so you can't guarantee a salary when you don't know the long-term spending. So Proposition CC doesn't solve the education funding problem. And in the same way, over years and years, Coloradans have been asked to give more of our tax money to fixing our roads. You know, there's faster fees increase, those are our vehicle registration fees increase all the time. Referendum fee was passed in 2005, was temporary, but it's still between those and the hospital provider fee a couple years ago, there's $3 billion more every year going towards our roads. And yet we have some of the worst roads in the country, especially our rural roads. And so we keep throwing money at these things because they're important to us. Education, roads is the number one issue that people say they want fixed, but we keep throwing money at it and it doesn't get fixed. So I don't know why we would add money to this, to these problems, you know, when we keep doing it and they're not getting better.
Proposition Double C is our topic. Lindsey, if you could hold on a second, we'll come back after a break here and have some more conversation. Judy wants to jump in on Lafayette. We'll talk to her as well. Everybody, hang tight. Let me take a quick break. It's News Talk 600 KCOL. My name is Jimmy. Hopefully, by the, again, this time of the day, you know your name, and I'm glad to have you here on the program. Ladies and gentlemen, you feel it. I mean, I know today's kind of a summer-like day in the next couple of days, but you know the days are getting shorter, the nights are getting cooler, and you've already had to turn your furnace on once or probably twice or a couple of days. Maybe it was on this morning. Listen, you need to make sure that furnace is going to last the entire duration of the Colorado winter. And to do that, I would recommend you have the folks at 1 Hour Heating and Air come out and do a little tune-up. They'll look deep inside the furnace unit that you have and see if there's any problems that are lurking on the horizon that could mean failure on a very cold night sometime this winter. At the techs of the 1 Hour Heating and Air, they know Colorado well. They know what the special attention your furnace may need. If you know your system needs repair, then they also have straightforward pricing, so you're not going to be surprised. You're going to know exactly what you're paying for before the work has even started. I use them at the Lakey Estate. I had to do a HVAC replacement, heating and air conditioning replacement at my place, oh gosh, about almost 2 years ago, and doggone it, I was a customer of theirs and still am. They do a tune-up at least twice a year. I bring them out for both seasons, air conditioning and heating season. 1 Hour Heating and Air. Have them come out to your place. I'm a customer. You should be as well. They're my guys. 855-1-HOUR, 855-1-HOUR. Tell them Jimmy Lakey's talking about him on the radio, 855-1-HOUR. All right, take a quick break. Come back here in just a moment, and I'll take calls. I'll also talk to Lindsey Singer, Colorado Rising Action. She's with me next on News Talk 600 KCOL.
Honey, use Airwick VIP pre-poop toilet spray.
Mom!
You spray it before you go to trap nasty odors in the bowl.
Mom, I don't do that.
Honey, a mother knows best. Find Airwick VIP in the cleaning aisle or on Amazon.
Hey, it's Harley, owner of Window Nation. You know, my brother Aaron always gives me a hard time because I'm a terrible cook. Oh boy, and he's not kidding. So I believe in leaving the cooking to the experts. Harley burned a salad once. See, here at Window Nation, we're proud to be the window experts. We've installed over 500,000 windows in over 65,000 homes. Our service techs have an average of 15 years of experience. And we're ranked the fifth largest window retailer in the country by Remodeling Magazine. 25% of our business comes from homeowners who hired window guys that didn't do the job right the first time.
Like how you scramble eggs?
We get it, Aaron.
Right now at Window Nation, buy two windows, get two free. Buy four windows, get four free. Buy six windows, get six free. All with 0% interest for 5 years. That's 60 months interest free. You won't find a better deal anywhere else. Call now or visit windownation.com. That's windownation.com for your free estimate.
Dr. Brian Sabak, double board certified neurosurgeon, spine expert, and age management specialist, has opened a boutique practice, Sabak Spinal Solutions in Arlington. On the campus of Virginia Hospital Center, a Mayo Clinic affiliate, he provides non-surgical and holistic treatment options in addition to surgery. Dr. Sabak specializes in minimally invasive and robotic surgery and treats patients with disc herniations, spinal stenosis, and degenerative arthritis. Find Dr. Sabak online at SabakSpinalSolutions.com.
Your attention, please. Introducing the king of savings, King Kia. Fall in love with our low, low prices, like the new 2019 Kia Forte for only $14,999. And drive off in the new 2019 Kia Soul for only $16,999. Plus, 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty program on all new Kias. Get a lot more savings from the king of savings, King Kia, or KingAutoKia.com.
2019 Kia Forte LXS Automatic, MSRP $20,240. Dealer discount and factory rebates to dealer. 2019 Kia Soul, MSRP $23,135. Dealer discount and factory rebates to dealer. Plus tax, title, tag, freight, and $300 processing fee. Offer expires 10/31/19.
For many students, cost is one of the biggest concerns about college. And with good reason. Between tuition, living expenses, books, and fees, college can be very expensive. At Frostburg State University, they want you to know that that doesn't mean college is out of reach. There are lots of resources available to help you. Start by filling out an FAFSA form. Invest in yourself and get started today. Frostburg State University. One university, a world of experiences. Frostburg.edu for more.
Coming to the Warner Theater. On October 18th, the most dynamic and distinctive band of survivors in soul music, Tower of Power, celebrate 50 years with special guest, the Chuck Brown Band. October 19th, Dennis DeYoung of Styx celebrates the 40th anniversary of The Grand Illusion. And October 20th, it's a 50-year celebration of the Beatles' White Album, featuring Christopher Cross, Todd Rundgren, Mickey Dolenz, Jason Scheff, and Joey Mollen. Tickets for these shows and more at the Warner Theater box office or LiveNation.com.
Love beautiful jewelry? Want to make a difference on your campus and give back to those in need? We're looking for college ambassadors for Comaria.com. Beautiful designer jewelry where every purchase supports campus sexual assault survivors. 10% of all proceeds directly cover tuition, medical, and housing for students in higher education. Join us now. Comaria.com. That's K-A-M-A-R-I-A.com. Everyone knows someone. Help prove they're not alone. Restore their dignity. Comaria.com.
Your home for the Huskers. News Talk 600 KCOL.
She's a good girl. Loves her mama. Loves Jesus. In America too.
All right, nice to have you. Great to have you here on the show. It's News Talk 600 KCOL. Well, let's bring back Lindsey Singer back in. Colorado Rising Action, the website you can learn more about, Proposition Double C, that's on your Colorado ballot. That probably mine arrived yesterday. I think we checked the mail the day before, so it arrived yesterday. And go to VoteNoOnCC.com, VoteNoOnCC.com. Lindsey, for those people who maybe are new, over a decade and a half ago, a long time ago, a couple of decades ago, Coloradoans passed the Taxpayer Bill of Rights, and that basically says local or state government has to seek voter approval before raising taxes. And you are correct. What this does is, and also any government surplus has to be sent back to the people. And what they're going to do is the Tabor refund that we should all be getting in the next year, it says, nope, you don't get that back. So that is, as you said, an effective tax increase, and we are basically voting to let them keep more money than what they were originally supposed to keep. This is a tax increase you're voting for if you vote yes on CC.
That's right. And the ballot language, when you look at your ballot, starts out without raising taxes, which is sort of word games because they'll argue that, well, it's not raising tax rates. That's true, but it's surely raising your tax liability because you're not getting that money back in your pocket.
The ballot language, let me read it to you because it's kind of a cornucopia. That's my fall word of the season, cornucopia. They throw it all in here. It's not just the children, it's everything. Without raising taxes and to better fund public schools, higher education, roads, bridges, and transit within a balanced budget, may the state keep and spend all the revenue it annually collects after June the 30th, 2019, but is not currently allowed to keep under the Colorado law with an independent audit to show how the retained revenues are spent. They throw it all in here. It's not just for the schools. They say this is magically, if we do this, our roads are going to be better, our bridges are going to be better, transportation, higher education, public schools. It's a cornucopia. They threw all the reasons in here to jerk the heartstrings of us. But the point is, none of that's required. It's all looks good on paper, but there's nothing that requires them to spend it on any of that. Is that correct?
That's correct. Because it's in, so let me back up a little. The reason that the ballot language is allowed to say that is because it only had to be passed by the Democrat majority legislature. If you or I wanted something on the ballot, we would have to first collect signatures. It would have to go through a title board to approve the language that's on the ballot. And what's in here never would have gotten past the title board. But the legislature plays by a different set of rules. And so we've ended up with what we have here, which is completely misleading to voters. And really what the legislature wants is a bailout for some of their bad policies.
Yeah. It's very rare that you have newspapers like the Denver Post editorial board and the Colorado Springs editorial board finding a commonality or finding agreement. But Proposition Double C has brought together a lot of newspapers and more liberal editorial boards. And they even say that Proposition Double C is not the right fix for any woes of Colorado. That kind of lets you know the coalition coming together as to why this is bad.
Absolutely. And the Denver Post is no friend of the Taxpayers' Bill of Rights, to be sure. They still aren't. But the fact that they came out and said the legislature can do better, this would be a permanent change. They're not willing to endorse something that would be this permanent and this poorly planned out by the legislature, because it's not, while I agree and the Denver Post agrees that we do need to fix this to our education funding system, we do need our roads especially. We need a lot of help there, but this Proposition CC is not going to do that, and it's going to be a forever change, so we need to vote no.
There's been some misleading advertising. I know the No on CC organization has had to respond to some of the misleading advertising. What do you think is the most misleading thing that the folks from New York are buying television radio ads here about why to vote yes on CC? What's the most misleading of all the ones you've seen, the biggest lie they're telling about CC?
The biggest lie is that it's not raising taxes. And they say things... they basically, in their advertising, just restate the ballot language, which is misleading in itself. But they'll say, this will help, this will fix our roads, this will give teachers more money, which is actually not true. We cannot pay teachers more with the money from Proposition CC, because we're not sure that it'll be stable in the future. But every part of it, without raising taxes, we're giving up more of our taxes. It's all misleading, and it's all, like you said, paid for by out-of-state people who, really, their priority is to let the government keep more money without having to ask pesky voters whether we approve of it or not.
I hope people, usually there's a title board when there's a ballot initiative that gets put on there, but that's a very important point of order that you just made, because this is not a citizen-led initiative. This is put on by the legislature. They did not have to go through the ballot language and the title board on this thing. They kind of got to create their own rules here, and living by rules that we would never get to live by, and obviously the fruit of that is kind of a misleading language on a ballot.
Absolutely. All they had to do was pass this ballot language with a simple majority through the majority Democrat legislature, and that's what happened.
What is your sense? Ballots have dropped. People are going to start voting. They already have started voting. Is there any sense as to how this is going? It seems as if a lot of the newspapers, even today, I think the Arvada paper came out and said this is bad. It seems as if at the last minute, a lot of people are coming out and say, yeah, Proposition Double C, not good. But obviously, millions of dollars being spent on out-of-state money. Is there any sense for momentum on from you at Colorado Rising Action and the Vote No on CC? Anybody sensing how this is going to turn out?
Yeah, it's a good point you made about the editorial boards, not just the Denver Post and the Gazette, but there's a group of at least 18 local papers that have come out against it this week. And this is a really important week because ballots are right in front of people and they can vote on it and send it back any time. And so we're trying to get out at the grassroots level and talk on shows and talk to people personally, but we're hoping that's enough to go up against the over $2 million that's coming in from out of state. When you look at polling, there's been some private polling where people just see the ballot language and they're much more likely to vote yes on this. When you have these conversations that we're having with people and explain a little bit about it, that it's not guaranteed to go where they say and that it is a tax increase and it's forever, people are much more reluctant to vote yes on this. So that's what we're trying to do. That's why I'm hoping you and all your listeners can continue to talk to people before they send their ballots in this week.
That's Lindsey Singer. She's with Colorado Rising Action. The website you can go to for to learn more about CC is votenoonCC.com. VotenoonCC.com. And Lindsey, I just remind all my listeners, how many times have they told us, if you let us raise taxes on this or this or this, they increase the fee or a tax. They told us the roads would be fixed. They told us the schools would be fixed. They've told us this. So we've heard the same song, different verse over and over again. And you have to ask yourself, how many more times will we be fooled to continue to give these people more money of our money when they haven't even performed well with the money that we've already given them? So I would say vote no on CC, Lindsey. And if you want to come back on, we'll get Michael Fields back on, but love to have it and continue the conversation.
Absolutely. Thanks so much for having us.
You got it. Lindsey Singer. And again, go to votenoonCC.com to learn more. But it is a permanent giving up of your tax refund if you vote yes on this thing. It says without raising taxes. That's a stretch, because it's a refund that's supposed to.